What's up, guys? Welcome back to our channel, Three Layers of Wellness. I'm Blair McClendon, your health and wellness life coach. And I am back with six frequently asked questions about yoga, part two, from our question and answer series from Quora. Number one, do you think yoga is a form of therapy? I believe yoga is a great form of individual therapy, allowing you to connect with your truest self by becoming aware of your body and the things that are restricting you from becoming what you would call free and living a life of peace. As you practice and release certain blocks, energy flows freely throughout the body, sometimes bringing emotion or clarity about a certain situation to the surface. Number two, what is the real purpose of yoga that people have lost sight of? I believe that the real purpose of yoga is to unite your mind, body, and your spirit, to truly bring yourself into one in the present moment. I think nowadays yoga has somewhat been commercialized, especially in the Western world, into more so workouts and exercises for most. So the lost sight would be leaving out the true practice and conscious piece of it. Number three. Which brings faster results, yoga or the gym? Really, it depends on the type of results you're looking for. Your diet always being the foundation is the key. Once you're in control of your diet, it makes everything else easier. I would actually recommend a combination of doing both yoga and the gym to get the exact results that you want in the fastest way possible. In my opinion, the gym is for building muscles while yoga allows you to help stretch and recover. So to me, it's a good 1-2 punch. It's something that I do. I do yoga pretty much every day, and then I do the gym every other day. Question four, can we really become slim through yoga? Again, yoga can definitely help thin you out depending on the type of practice, but it all starts with diet and nutrition. If you're eating healthy along with doing yoga, your body will definitely start to change and you will see results rather quickly. If you're looking to thin out and lose a little bit of weight, I would suggest maybe a vinyasa flow or doing some hot yoga. Number five, does face yoga really help get rid of wrinkles? This is a practice I haven't particularly tried, but I can see how it could help get rid of wrinkles. A major component of yoga, as mentioned in the other videos, is breathing throughout the body to release trapped emotion. I've noticed with my own skin that just the wrinkles in my forehead are not as defined as they once were, what I used to call thinking lines. Some mornings I wake up and I don't have any at all, and especially after doing yoga, prior to getting into bed and just being more relaxed before I go to sleep. Once I wake up that next morning, it carries over. So I know it took a little bit of time, and it's all about you just being in tune with your body and releasing again those trapped emotions, trapped tension. And as you start to do that, your face will loosen up or tighten up in a sense to where you're not seeing those wrinkles. Question six, what do you clean your non-slip yoga mat with? Some natural ways I've found to clean the yoga mat is by mixing some of the following ingredients into a spray bottle, spraying and just lightly scrubbing. Witch hazel or white vinegar, distilled or spring water, tea tree oil, lemon, lavender, or peppermint essential oils, soft cloth or a sponge, and then of course your spray bottle. Hopefully you found this video helpful. Again, always like, share, subscribe. Don't forget to check out our website, threelayerswellness.com, where I have blog posts full of many more resources and tools for your knowledge. Also do one-on-one coaching, so reach out if you need help with any of that stuff. And then don't forget to follow us on Instagram at @threelayersofwellness. And stay tuned on YouTube for more videos like this. Again, hit that thumbs up, like, share, subscribe. And we will talk to you soon. Peace.